Have you ever thought about the ridiculous amount of hours tens of thousands of players put into RuneScape? Is this because RuneScape has an addictive factor to it? Well, that's what we will be covering in this video. Is RuneScape addictive? So grab your cup of tea, sit back, relax, and enjoy. RuneScape is a game that started back in 2001, and it's still one of the most popular games to date. RuneScape was the childhood of millions of people, and it has most definitely made a massive impact on most young adults' lives. RuneScape is also one of those games you keep coming back to, more so than 99% of the other games out here today that you might play one time and then never return back to. This is where the statement, "you can never quit RuneScape," comes from, and that every single player has at least heard of once if you've been playing since the golden era of RuneScape. This raises the two main questions of this video: why do so many people keep returning to RuneScape, and is RuneScape addictive? There are so many reasons why people return to RuneScape, whether they go ahead and play the older, more nostalgic version called Old School RuneScape, or return to the slightly less popular main game called RuneScape 3. Returning players usually return because they get a reminder that RuneScape still exists. This can happen by them suddenly remembering RuneScape, getting a video in their YouTube recommended, a friend mentioning the game to them, and various other reasons. They then return to the game to realize they either love the game or don't want to waste more time on it, but this clearly depends on the individual. The ones that do stick around, however, will end up making money in-game, finishing their goals from the childhood, or setting up a new goal or goals to go for. The current and returning players that stick around clearly adore this game that is over a decade old, because why else would they put so many hours into this game? I personally have over 6,000 hours in this game since I first started out in 2004. Though, to be fair, at least 60% of those hours are me AFKing while doing something else. With the exception of some legendary games like Minecraft and Diablo 3, there aren't that many games out there that I put more than 100 hours in. In fact, the most games I have played, I only have around 10 to 50 hours in. I don't think I'm just talking for myself here either. I'm pretty sure there are many people out there that don't play most of their games for more than the previously mentioned 10 to 50 hours. So how come that I and many others have so many hours in RuneScape, whether that's RuneScape 3 or old school? Is it because RuneScape is addictive? Well, to answer that question, I first need to explain the definition of addiction. Addiction is the repeated involvement with a substance or activity, no matter what it would cause, good or bad. Addiction can lead to harm and health issues depending on what type of addiction it is. Now, clearly, RuneScape isn't a substance like drugs. However, playing RuneScape is an activity, and there are definitely people out there that are or have been seriously addicted to playing this game. And let's be fair here. Being addicted to RuneScape isn't exactly healthy, as your body is not engaged in any physical activity whatsoever. Playing RuneScape or any other video game for that matter for a prolonged period of time can lead to fatigue, migraines, which is a severe headache, carpal tunnel syndrome, blood clots, and in extreme rare cases, even death. That sounded dramatic, didn't it? In all honesty, I don't think there are many people out there that are dangerously addicted to playing RuneScape. However, I do think that there are a lot of players out there that are lightly addicted to playing RuneScape. So let's do a little test or quiz. I'm going to be listing some questions on screen now. Be sure to carefully read these questions and answer them truthfully. If you have answered at least one of those questions with yes, then you might be at least a little addicted to RuneScape. But not to worry, because being slightly addicted to RuneScape or any other video game for that matter doesn't mean your life is doomed at all. It could just mean it's a big hobby of yours. Now that we've covered that, let's move on to how RuneScape keeps you playing and what the actual addictive factors are. RuneScape is a game with lots of numbers, and research shows us that humans like big and round numbers. In RuneScape, you can gain experience and gold pieces, also known as GP. both of which at the core are just pixel numbers. The biggest thing that keeps people playing any video game is achieving a goal or being able to grind towards more goals. In RuneScape, goals are usually focused around getting a set amount of numbers. For example, the amount of XP you need for a 99. Or gathering a certain amount of in-game gold to get a special virtual item that resembles wealth. Because just like in the real world, you want to show off your wealth, at least to some extent. Take a Rolex or a Lamborghini, for example. People adore these luxury things because they look good, but also because they resemble wealth. Which again leads to my point of big numbers. If we as humans know something costs more, we will in most cases, at least the majority of people, like that particular something much, much more, and so will others. Now before I go way off topic, let's get back to RuneScape. RuneScape has implemented an incredible system to keep you playing. Gaining experience in RuneScape is usually satisfying, and you have many, many milestones ranging from leveling up, virtual levels, total experience, and experience milestones like 1 billion total experience or 200 mil in one skill. However, this doesn't mean everyone is a fan of this system, but it is something that keeps players going on and on for much longer. So in a way, there's a big replayability factor in RuneScape, both in Old School and RuneScape 3. For the people that don't find enjoyment in gaining experience, you can also hoard wealth or other virtual items in RuneScape, something rather common in many other large MMOs. Let me just give you guys an example of how RuneScape keeps you hooked. You start by non-actively going for a goal. You do this by barely trying. Then you get to a point where you think, oh, I've gained this much money or experience, let's take experience for this example, and you then start grinding out that skill to get, again, for a goal, maybe a virtual 120 or a 99, and just keep on going until you're finished. And once you're finished, you feel satisfied and proud for a few days until that feeling is completely gone out of your system, and you're hungry for more. Or you think, well, that wasn't so bad, I can do that again, and boom, you repeat the process. Again, you're playing this game much longer than you initially planned. Again, this isn't for everyone. Some people might just get bored and quit instead. Everyone's different, but this example is 100% prominent in at least some of the players of RuneScape. Another way of keeping players hooked to RuneScape is by RuneScape having dynamic goals. Dynamic goals in RuneScape are goals that can change. Some examples of this would be the Completionist Cape or Quest Cape. Both of these big achievements can be lost at any given point in time when a new comp requirement is added or a new quest is added to the game, and therefore make you feel like you need to get it back, and this is actually disgusting if you think about it, because this way you'll keep playing and playing until you either get really bored or you're just in a never-ending addictive loop. Dynamic goals are also a big reason why players come back to the game. I mean, just look at how many players came back to RuneScape to get their max cape back, or comp cape, when the invention skill was released in RuneScape 3 in 2016. I really wanted to make a video on this topic because I think this is something that isn't talked about too often throughout the community of RuneScape. Yet it's something that may well be more common than we all think. I personally have at one point felt the need to constantly grind this game to achieve 120 constitution, also known as hit points. I remember AFKing at the Abyss on the side while studying for my exams for maximum efficiency. I remember putting down a laptop next to my TV to keep on AFKing while watching TV, or even using remote Chrome desktop on my phone to keep my account going and logged in. Looking back at this moment, I'm a bit confused as to why I didn't have the patience to take it slow. This might have been because of the fact that I too was a little addicted to the experience gaining system, or I might have just been really driven to achieve the goal, as many more followed. Thankfully, I now only play when I feel like it or when I want to make a video. So, I again would like to ask you, the viewer, have you ever felt this way at some point playing RuneScape? And if so, do you think it's because RuneScape is addictive or not? Let me know down in the comments below. Thanks for watching, I was your host, the Tea Addicted Dutchman. Peace.